So you saw the thumbnail, you already know what it is. I finally got them, the Air Jordan 4 Off-White Sale. Yes, it came out in women's, it may not fit me, but I'ma still do this review. Welcome back to the channel. What's up with you guys? How you doing? How you been? If you did not know by now, my name is DJ and this is the DNA Show. Now, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, join the family, join the squad. We on our way to 100K. I know we only at 70K right now, but trust me, we gonna get there by the end of the year. So smash the subscribe button and don't forget to hit that like button because that helps the algorithm oh so much. But with all that being said, let's go ahead and get into this video. Starting with this sneaker right here, we obviously can tell we have the Air Jordan 4 box like we normally see, but they did a little bit different and they went with the similar style like they did with the Air Jordan 5 Off-White, how they had the holes in the box with the clear see-through right here. And then you got the holes here on the back side, other side, and then your classic front right here on the front of the box. So looking at the top of the box, you got your red Jumpman right here with the white flight, and then on the size tag you have women's Air Jordan 4 Retro SP Sale Muslin White Black, retail $200. So in today's video I will be comparing the Off-White Air Jordan 5 just to talk about the materials and the similarities with this one. I think they have some similarities with the sock liner and then around some of the materials on the foot, so we'll check that out with the comparison later in the video. But for right now, let's go ahead and get into this shoe. Let's crack this box open. Starting with the box, as you can see, we got the clear paper Jumpman logo, Off-White with the see-through branding right here, and then we have the shoe. Oh, we got the shoe. So my initial thought when I first see this shoe is, yes, these are extremely dope, but for some reason they remind me of something. And then I started to think about it, the Hander Scheme 4s, bruh, they're literally like the same exact shoe, but it's the Off-White version. A little bit tweaked, but it's the same colorway concept. I don't know what you guys think, but I feel like maybe they might have got some inspiration from that. Who knows? But anyways, let's go ahead and get into this review. Starting with the outsole, you have kind of like a sail here on the back of the foot, a white on the midfoot, a mint green Nike logo, a mint here on the ball of the foot, a translucent sail here, kind of like a gum look, but it's not completely gum, more kind of light tan area. And then here at the toe of the foot, you got that same kind of sail color that you see at the back. Honestly, just the color scheme on the sole alone, I'm already digging them. Working our way up to the midsole, you still have the translucent area, working our way to the side of the foot right here. And then on the back, you have the sale with the white paint mixed half and half, and then your air branding in quotes on the side. Looking at the air bubble, we have a white air unit right here. Going to the front of the foot, you have a tan stitch here at the toe line, and then you have a sale pod right here on the side of the foot as well. And bruh, I'm telling you, these are really nice. Taking our way to the upper, there is a lot to talk about. I'm gonna start with the back of the foot first and work my way to the front. So starting with the back, you have a Nike Air with the see-through branding right here. It's really, really dope. I like the concept, how you can kind of see the back end of the foot where it's kind of like two-toned with the black here at the bottom. And a lot of people know, when you have the Nike Air on a shoe, especially a Jordan 4, Jordan 3, Jordan 5, Jordan 6, something like that, it just makes it a little bit better. Following that translucent plastic vibe, we have the same touches here on the arm of the foot, the netting here on the side and on the tongue, and then the eyelets here at the bottom of the foot. Touching the leather and the materials right here on the side of the foot and all throughout the upper, I'm telling you right now, it is so soft. The quality is there. It almost feels like it's a suede, like a nubuck or something, but that leather is literally so buttery. It's just like, I don't even know what to compare this shoe to when it comes to that material, when it comes to like a Jordan 4 especially. I really love how they went with the perforated edges here on the side of the foot at the top, and then the other part of the panel here around the ankle. I think that's really dope. Instead of having that stitch line, giving that perforated look like the seams were just taken out, I think that's really clean. Working our way to the toe of the foot and the mud guard, this is something that I was talking about before. You kind of got that ripstop material here that runs around the front of the foot right here all the way around the toe, and it looks like the same exact material, same exact pattern, just a different color as the Air Jordan 5, which we will compare in a second. And then you have that same material here on the tongue of the foot as well. So these come equipped with four pairs of laces. You got your black, you got your mint, you got your white, and then you have your sail colored laces. And similar to all the other Off-White releases, we have the same thing here on the inside of the foot. You have your Off-White branding, Air Jordan 4, Beaverton, Oregon, 1989, and that is the year that the original Air Jordan 4 released. Now looking at the left foot, that one comes with the Off-White zip tab right here. It's in that sail colorway, and very faintly you can see Off-White 2020 zip tie right here. And then it also comes with the Air Jordan 4 hang tag, something that I really love. Now when we talk about other sneakers that are $200 retail, different things like that, you don't really get all these lace options, hang tags, zip ties, all these other things that come with the shoe, especially the quality behind this sneaker. Now, if we want to talk about quality and everything like that, this shoe is easily a $400 or $500 shoe. We've seen other shoes retail at that price and they've been okay. And I think these right here could retail for that price. Again, resale is a lot higher, but me personally, just based off of quality and everything like that, I'm really loving these. So now let's compare these to the Air Jordan 5 Off-White that came out earlier into the year. I know a lot of people didn't like this one at first, and then they started to love it later. And I feel like it's kind of that same vibe with this sneaker. The price was high, it's starting to go down. Then next thing you know, it started to work its way back up. And that's exactly what happened with these. I think that same situation is gonna happen with this shoe as well. But I wanna talk about the materials around the toe. This one's frayed a little bit more around the edges, but if you look at the materials right here, you can see they're very, very identical. They're pretty much the same exact thing. And I like how they're incorporating the new elements to the sneaker. That's more, I guess, durable and more reliant compared to the Air Jordan 1 Chicago Off-White, how everybody knew those literally just shredded and then the shoe started to fall apart. So I think incorporating this new material and innovating over the past couple years and making the shoe being able more built to last, I think that's a very dope touch to have it on this sneaker right here. Another thing that I was talking about earlier as well is the sock liner. If you look at the sock liner right here, it's not as detailed. There's pretty much kind of like one layer on this one. And this one's kind of more layered with two or three layers where you got your tan, you got a white, a tan, and a white and again, and then a tan on the sock line. And this one's a little bit more minimal. It's not as thick around the ankle. And I think a lot of people didn't like how it was so flimsy at the top right here. And I think probably it was because it lacked a little bit of padding. And they could have learned from their mistake on this one on how they created and constructed this sneaker and said, okay, maybe we can make a better version by doing it here on this Air Jordan 4 and not making it as flimsy and making it more sturdy but still durable at the same time. Drop a comment down below and let me know which one you guys like the most. Do you like the Air Jordan 4 or do you like the Air Jordan 5? Or do you just not like either one at all? Let me know down below in the comment section. Me personally, if this shoe came out in my size, and I think a 14 and a half might be out to the public, I'm not exactly sure. I gotta check and see because some people saying yes, some people saying no. If there is a 14 and a half available in women's size, let me know. I'm trying to find a pair, but I would get these if I could, and then I would probably go for these second. I know these would be easier to rock just because it's a dark shoe and it's black, and if it gets messed up, you really wouldn't be able to tell. These are probably gonna be like a dirt magnet. I mean, just the way it's set up with the colorway and everything, it's kind of hard not to get these dirty. But at the same time, I have seen a bunch of women rocking these lately on IG. They've been killing it, looking oh so fresh with them on their feet. And honestly, I salute y'all because, man, right here, y'all got a good one. So I went to IG like I always do. If you haven't already, follow me on IG. I always like to post a poll and ask the people what do they think so I can share the results with you guys. And if you want to participate in any of the polls or get any exclusive information on my IG that I never post on YouTube, go ahead and follow me on there. But basically, like I always do, I ask the people, are these fire or are these trash? 90% said fire, 10% said trash. And I can understand where everybody is coming from. This shoe is extremely dope. I don't think it's the best. I don't think it's none of that. But when it comes to quality, for sure up there. Colorway, super solid, super clean. I wish I could get that black pair that's coming out. Honestly, I like those a little bit more. That's just me personally because I like darker shoes. But at the same time, if I could grab these in my collection in my size, oh yeah, I would for sure rock these. So let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Are these fire or are these trash? I would really love to know what you have to say about these. And if the fours are coming out in the black colorway, let me know. If that is actually happening, please let me know because I need those. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it's super late, me dropping it all late and everything. I've been hella busy. If you guys know, if some of you guys don't, I ended up picking that third house up like I said I would. And you know what that means. Video coming soon. I'm gonna give you guys a full house tour of the house. Gonna do a renovation, all those different things. Also, if you wanna see more information about that, follow my other YouTube channel because that will be more in-depth on, you know, the how-to, the financial side, and everything like that. I will be giving you guys a peek here on this channel, but again, I know if you guys are more interested into finance and real estate and everything like that, we can talk more about it on that channel because I know obviously we talk more about sneakers over here. But I am excited to show you guys that. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. You already know what to do, man. If you haven't already, like I said before, hit that subscribe button, man. We about to hit 100K. I don't know when, but we gonna hit it. All right, y'all. My name is DJ, I'm signing out. I got to go. I'm gone. Peace.